Buenas.
Hello, hello, welcome.
Hello, hello.
Okay, well, I'm going to start with this page, but this is just a reference, solamente como una referencia, porque obviamente no voy a leer toda la información que está acá porque no es el objetivo. So, complete the sentences. Ahí viene Genesis. Complete the sentence with the comparative or superlative. If you see, we have the adjective small, long, big, young, short, poor, y slow. Y eso es bien fácil. Vamos a pasar la oración a comparativa o vamos a pasar la oración a superlativa dependiendo del contexto. Por ejemplo, en la primera dice, India is smaller than Brazil. ¿Por qué usé comparativo? Porque aquí me está dando la referencia que es una oración en comparativo, donde dice que India es más pequeño que Brasil, es smaller. ¿Cómo creen que quedaría la segunda? El adjetivo es long. The coastline of, ¿qué país sería? ¿Canadá, Brasil o India? The coastline of is than coastline of Brazil. La costa de es más grande, porque aquí long aplica para cuando algo es grande como largo.
Ajá. I don't know, Amazonas.
Canadá. Ok, let's see. Yes, muy bien. The coastline of Canada is, compárate.
Longer.
Eso solamente longer. Es como referencia. Is longer than coastline of Brazil. Letter C. For example, India has comparative o superlative?
Superlative. Bigger.
No.
No. Bigger is comparative.
What?
India has. This is superlative. Biggest. Yes. No. India has the biggest.
Yes, obviously.
Casi se lo digo.
Almost. Okay. India has the biggest population. Hey, by the way, hey, I'm going to make a stop. We have a new student. Hello, Walter. Welcome. Your microphone is on, Walter, but I can hear you. Hello, hello, Walter.
Hello.
Okay, hi. How are you?
Good.
Excellent. How was your day? Good?
It was a little busy.
Okay. Are you nervous? Are you exciting? Or what?
I'm a little nervous and a little excited.
Okay. Well, hey, welcome to your English class, okay?
Okay, thanks.
Nice. You're welcome. Okay, to continue. Letter D. Brazil and India have younger population than Canada, Brazil, or India? Brazil and India have younger population than? Ajá. Me quedé sin alumnos. Ajá. Oh my God, it's really easy. Anybody
llamada.
Estás haciendo uñas también, o como dijo.
No, la que te me están llamando.
Okay, no, don't worry. Please. Ajá. Brazil and India have younger population than. The comparative is younger, más joven que, o sea, la población más joven que than. Oh my God, it's true? My goodness, it's easy. Solo tenemos tres países, señores. Brazil, India have the younger population than?
Canada.
Oh my goodness, thank you. Let's see, thank you so much. Canada, next. For example, you say, India has comparative o superlative. ¿Cuál vamos a utilizar? India has. What is high? Ajá. The comparative. Ok. So, the superlative of high is?
Highest.
Ok, thank you so much. India has the highest birth rate. Next. people in India have the adjective is short. Ajá. Comparative or superlative?
Superlative.
Are you sure?
Yeah, because oh no. Comparative.
Ajá. Okay.
Shorter.
The shorter lives than people in Brazil. Esto es solamente como referencia. Acuérdense, para los que ingresaron un poquito tarde, solo estoy haciendo como una pequeña referencia de los comparativos y los superlativos. Letter G, for example, India is. ¿Superlative o comparative?
Superlative.
Ok, solo un alumno tengo hoy. Genesis, Valeria, what happened with you, Jasmine? India is the...
The poorest,
el más pobre. The poorest country of the three. And the last one, the economy of Brazil has, la economía de Brasil. The economy of Brazil has
the slowest
growth rate. Okay, this is just for reference. Teacher, I feel this was very, very difficult. No, my goodness, it's very easy. You have to practice now. Okay, look at number one. We have the comparative and the superlative. Write the comparative and superlative form of the adjectives. For example, we have the adjective quiet. Eso es solo un review. Acuérdense que lo vimos el viernes. Quiet, the comparative, quiet. Superlative, the quietest. Economical. What is the comparative? Economical, yes? We have
an adjective. More economical.
Okay, let's see. More economical. And the superlative?
Most economical.
Okay, most economical. Perdón, Genesis y Valeria, me avisan si tienen bien el audio, porfa, thank you. Comfortable, comparative.
More comfortable.
Thank you, Cari. More comfortable. Superlative.
Most comfortable.
Most comfortable. Excellent. Easy, fácil. Comparative.
Easier.
Gracias. Easier. Cuando terminan con Y, acuérdense que cambia la estructura. Easier. Superlative.
Easiest.
Excellent. The easiest. Quick. Comparative.
Quicker.
Superlative.
Quickest.
The quickest. Noisy.
Noisier.
Superlative.
Noisier.
Clever.
Cleaver.
Muy bien. Cleaver. Superlative.
Cleverest.
The cleverest. Exciting. Tenemos tres sílabas.
More exciting.
More exciting. Superlative.
Most exciting.
Most exciting. Soft.
Softer.
Softer. Superlative.
Softest.
Smooth.
Smoother.
The superlative.
Smoothest.
The smoothest. Okay, thank you. Can you please, Valeria, help me to read the instruction? Number two. Thank you. Your microphone is on, but I cannot hear you, Bali. Yes, it's still on, but I can hear you. Let's see, Genesis, what happened with you? Can you please help me too? It is okay. Okay, thank you, Genesis. Please, number two.
Write the option opposite using the adjectives in the box.
Thank you. Can you please, Jasmine, help me to read? Just read the adjectives.
Difficult, cheap, old, noisy, light, narrow, slow, cool, clean, far, beautiful, sad, dangerous, interesting.
Interesting. Walter, activemos micrófonos, please. Walter, can you please help me to translate the adjectives? For example, difficult is?
Difícil.
Cheap.
Barato.
Barato. Yo tengo, okay, old.
viejo.
Okay, viejo o antiguo, aplica para objetos también. Noisy.
Ruidoso.
Light.
luminoso, creo.
Liviano, cuando algo es liviano. Narrow.
Narrow, I don't know.
Ok, cuando algo es ancho, por ejemplo, the door is narrow. Slow.
Lento.
Excellent, cool.
Nice.
Ok, take a high, yes. Clean.
Limpio.
Far.
Lejos.
Beautiful.
Hermoso.
Sad.
Triste.
Dangerous.
Peligroso.
Interesting.
Interesante.
Excelente. Vamos a escribir lo opuesto. Por ejemplo, en este caso, si usted se fija, todos los adjetivos ya están en comparativo. Entonces, ahora voy a escribir el comparativo, pero lo opuesto. Thank you, Walter. Ok, por ejemplo, tengo easier. Más fácil que. Por ejemplo, ¿cómo digo en este caso? Valeria, creo que tenía problemas con audio. ¿Cómo digo en este caso? Cristian, activemos micrófonos. Inglés es más fácil que español.
English is easier than Spanish.
Thank you. English is easier than Spanish. Lo contrario de easier es more difficult, más difícil. Vamos con el siguiente, quieter. ¿Cuál sería el opuesto? Aquí les da las respuestas también, de aquí lo van a sacar, no van a andar inventando nada. Por ejemplo, quieter, ¿cuál sería el opuesto?
Noisy.
Comparative.
Noisier.
Ok, thank you. Noisier. Vamos con letra C. Can you please, Genesis? Tengo dirtier. ¿Cuál sería lo opuesto en comparativo? Ajá. O any volunteer, yes. Pilas con clean. Los audios.
Cleaner.
Cleaner, comparativo. Acuérdense que vamos a pasarlo solo comparativo. Thank you, Yasmin. Tengo Cristian. Cleaner. Vamos con uglier. ¿Cuál sería el opuesto?
More beautiful.
Excelente. Bienvenida, Marce. More beautiful. Vamos con more boring. ¿Cuál sería en este caso el comparativo?
More interesting.
More interesting.
Excelente, thank you. More interesting. Vamos con heavier. Cuando algo es más pesado que heavier, comparative. Entonces, in this way, o the opposite.
Lighter.
Lighter. Excelente, lighter. Muy bien. Vamos con nearer. Cuando algo es más cercano que lo opuesto. Walter lo tradujo. Ajá.
Far.
Por ahí vamos, farther, muy bien, farther. Vamos con warmer, cuando algo es cálido o más cálido que. Walter lo tradujo como algo genial, pero en realidad cool puede ser algo.
Colder.
Cooler.
Vamos a ver, cooler, muy bien. Cooler. Vamos con wider, cuando algo es angosto. ¿Cuál sería lo opuesto?
More narrow.
Muy bien, narrow, en este caso, en este caso, ahí fue error mío de dedo, con ER, narrower, con ER, ahí fue error mío de dedo. Vamos con happier, más feliz que, lo contrario. Sadder, muy bien, sadder. Acuérdense, como tenemos una doble consonante, en medio de una vocal se le agrega la otra consonante, eso creo que lo vimos el viernes también. Faster, ¿cuál es lo contrario de más rápido que?
Slower.
Slower. Muy bien. More expensive. Más caro que. ¿Cuál sería lo contrario?
Cheaper.
Cheaper. Muy bien. Más barato que. Acuérdense que todos están ahorita en comparativo. Cheaper. Safer. Cuando algo, por ejemplo, un lugar es más seguro que el otro. Safer, lo contrario.
More dangerous.
Muy bien. Y vamos con el último. Younger. Más joven que. Lo contrario.
Older.
En este caso, older. Aplica para personas, animales, objetos, etc. Ok, please. En equation 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Pay attention to my examples. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 adjectives. Number 1, big. Number 2, hot. Number 3, fat. 4, difficult, and number 5, important. For example, in this case, my dreams are big. comparative, my dreams are bigger than yours. It's not necessary to say my dreams are bigger than your dreams. It's not necessary. If you want, you say just yours, que los tuyos. O sea, mis sueños, no el sueño que tenemos ahorita que ya me quiero ir a dormir, sino que mis sueños, mis metas, mis objetivos son más grandes que los tuyos. My dreams are bigger than yours. Comparative. The superlative form, my dreams are the biggest. Let's see, can you please, Marcela, activemos micrófonos. Se prepara Jasmine. Okay, please, Marcy. Invent three sentences using be, using adjective, comparative, and superlative. Whatever you want. If you want, you can use animals, people, objects, places. Yes, please.
Okay. My dog are big.
Plural or singular?
Singular.
Okay, one more time, please.
My dog is big.
Okay, good.
Okay. My dog is bigger than cats.
Okay, good. Superlative.
My dog is the biggest.
Perfect. Thank you. Jasmine, the same adjective, big. Using the normal adjective, comparative, and superlative, please. Se prepara Valeria. Thank you.
Okay. My car is big.
Good.
My car is bigger than
my brother's car, than yours, than my sister's car.
Than my sister's car.
Okay, superlative.
My car is the biggest.
Perfect. Vale, please. With the same adjective, big. Se prepara Jonathan.
My bed is big.
Good.
My bag is bigger than my mom.
Than my mom's bed.
My mom's bed.
Excellent. Superlative.
My bed is bigger.
My bed is the article. The,
is the biggest.
Porque de entender que es la más, la. El, acuérdense que el article significa el, los, la. Excelente, muy bien. Let's see, Jonathan, with the same adjective, please. Big.
Okay. The giraffe is big.
Good.
The giraffe is bigger than ant.
Excellent.
The giraffe is the biggest.
Perfect, thank you. Okay, the next adjective, hot. My example is, se va preparando Jeremy, por favor. Today is hot. O sea, así como, hey, qué calor. O sea, hoy ha sido un día bien caloroso. O sea, today is hot. Today is hotter than yesterday. O sea, hoy está más caliente que ayer. Today is hotter, hotter than yesterday. Superlative. Today is the hottest day. O sea, hoy ha sido el día más caliente. Today is the hottest day. Aquí no quise poner, por ejemplo, la vez pasada creo que puse San Salvador es más caliente que no sé qué. Creo que algo así puse. Hoy quise ocupar otro tipo de vocabulario. Jeremy, are you ready? Excellent. Thank you. Please, se prepara Christian.
Okay. My soap is hot.
Okay.
My soap is hotter than your soap.
Ah, okay. One more. Okay. Wait. The correct pronoun is soup.
Soup,
right? Yes. For example, soup. Because soap is jabón. Okay. Soap is jabón. Yes. With
¿Y
you.
¿Cómo se escriben los dos?
Okay, se lo mando ahorita. Ahí se los mando la diferencia.
Permítanme. Ajá, para diferenciar un poquito ahí.
Sopa. Soup. Soup. Ahí se los mando al chat.
Soup.
Soap. Jabón. Soap. Jabón. Entonces, soup. La primera, soap. O sea, sopa con U. Soup. Y jabón soup. Con U. Soap. Ok.
Ok.
One more time.
Ok. My soup is hot.
Good.
My soup is hotter than your soup.
Excellent.
And my soup is the hottest.
Is the hottest? Yes, perfect. Yes. That's it. Thank you. Christian, ready? Thank you, Christian. 5, 4, 3.
Sorry, sorry.
Okay. With the same, using hot. Excuse me, excuse me. Se prepara Walter. Okay, thank you, Christian. Go.
This day is hot. This day is hotter than yesterday. And this day is the hottest day in the year.
Okay, perfect. Excellent. Thank you. Walter, with the same adjective, hot, please.
April was hot.
Mm-hmm. Good.
April was hotter than today.
Excellent.
And April is the hottest month.
Excellent. Perfect. Thank you. Okay, let's continue with fat. My example is, this is a very easy adjective. For example, se prepara Valeria. My cat is fat. Comparate. My cat is fatter than your cat. Aquí podría utilizar, podríamos decir, my cat is fatter than yours. Pero aquí lo quise ocupar de otra forma. My cat is fatter than your cat. En the superlative, my cat is the fattest. Thank you, Vale. Se prepara Genesis.
My rabbit is fat.
Good.
My rabbit is fatter than rat.
Than a rat. Thank you. Next, superlative.
And my rabbit is the faster.
Is the fattest.
Fattest.
Excellent. Thank you. Genesis, are you ready?
Yes.
Wait, wait. Se prepara Marcela. Yes, thank you, Genesis. Go.
My dog is fat. My dog is fatter than your dog.
Mm-hmm.
My dog is the fattest.
Is the fattest. Thank you. Marce, se prepara Marcelo.
The pantera.
The panther.
The panther is fat. The panther is fatter than dog.
Okay.
And the panther is the fattest.
Is the fattest. Thank you. Okay, Marcelo, please, with the same adjective, fat.
Hello.
Hello. Are you ready?
Hello, teacher. yes.
Okay, please, with the adjective, fat.
Okay. My stepbrother is fat.
Good. Comparative.
My stepbrother is fatter than my older stepbrother.
Good. Uh-huh. Superlative.
my father is the fattest.
Fattest.
Forest.
Okay, my father is the fattest. Oh, my dad is the fattest. Thank you, Marcelo. Okay, continue with difficult. My example is, se prepara Walter. For example, to learn Japanese is difficult. Comparative. To learn Japanese is more difficult than learning English. This is my opinion. Superlative. To learn Japanese is the most difficult language to learn. Si usted se fija, cambié mucho el contexto en las tres oraciones. Sin embargo, las tres oraciones las ocupé siempre con el mismo adjetivo. Aquí lo único que cambió fue que aquí el adjetivo base es difficult. Comparativo, more difficult than. Superlativo, the most difficult. Ok, Walter, please, your example, se prepara Jeremy.
Drive a truck is difficult.
Good. Comparative.
dry trunk is more difficult than drive a car.
Excellent, superlative.
Trunks are the most difficult.
Transportation, maybe?
Transportation.
Okay, yes. Okay, perfect, thank you. Jeremy, please, your example using difficult se prepara Jasmine.
Okay. Play piano is difficult.
Good. Comparative.
Play piano is more difficult than play drums.
Excellent. Super Latin.
Play piano is the most difficult than play the drums.
Porque es superlative. El super, o sea, este podrías decir. To play piano is the most difficult instrument to learn or to play. O sea, es el instrumento más difícil de tocar. One more time. Okay. Superlative. Yes, one more time.
No era necesario de comparar, ¿verdad?
El comparativo solo es more difficult. Ahí sí, more difficult than. Superlativo, the most difficult. O sea, ya el superlativo porque supera a todos los demás. Yes.
Okay, entonces sería piano is the most difficult instrument.
Yes, perfect. That's it.
Okay.
Simple, yeah, excellent, thank it. You. Jasmine, please. Your example se prepara Marce.
Okay. To cook Chinese food is difficult.
To cook Chinese food is difficult. Next.
To cook Chinese food is more difficult than Italian food.
Excellent, superlative.
To cook Chinese food is the most difficult foods.
Excellent, to cook. Okay, Marce, okay, no, don't worry about it. Okay, let's continue with the last one, important. My example is, having breakfast is important. Desayunar es importante. Having breakfast is important. Comparative. Having breakfast is more important than having lunch or dinner. Esto solamente para referencia de del comparativo. Having breakfast is more, by the way, se prepara Christian con important. Having breakfast is more important than having lunch or dinner. Superlative. Having breakfast is the most important meal in the day. Christian, please, your example se prepara Jonathan.
For importance.
Yes, please.
Okay. Studying English is important.
Comparative.
Yeah. Studying English is more important than study, I don't know, flowers.
Flowers.
And yeah, people.
Oh. Yes, I got it. Like a biology.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Superlative. Okay.
Yeah. Study English is most important than study.
Superlative. Ya cuando tenés el superlative, no es necesario utilizar than, porque eso supera a todos. Okay, el than solo es para comparativo. Yes. One more time.
Study English is the most important. Study flowers.
Porque seguís comparando. Ahí puede ser. To study English is the most important language ever, por ejemplo.
Study English is
o si querés, comparame dos idiomas. Vamos con compárate otra vez, pero comparame dos idiomas mejor.
Okay. Study English is more important than Hindu.
Okay. Superlative.
Study English is the most important
language, hasta ahí.
Okay.
Yeah, the most important, el superlativo. O sea, estudiar inglés es lo más importante. O sea, estamos hablando inglés, pero puede ser cualquier idioma, obviamente. Pero aquí cuando ya tenemos el superlativo, ya no necesitamos comparar y volver a decir, es más importante que, superlativo en el inglés que supera, en este caso, a todos los demás. Ok.
Ok.
Perdón a quien mencioné para important. Ay, se me olvidó a quien había mencionado. Please, please, please.
Yo.
Ok, Jonathan, thank you. Important, please. Se prepara Genesis.
The word is important in our lives.
Okay, comparative.
The word is more important than play video games.
Good, superlative.
The word is the most important in our life.
Okay, excellent, thank you. Genesis, I'm going to finish with you, with important, please. Thank you. Hello, hello, Genesis. Are you ready? 5, 4, 3, 2. I don't know what happened with your audio. Please let me know. Jasmine, please, with important. Thank you, Jasmine. Hello, hello, Jasmine. Audio, señores. Thank you, Jasmine.
Ya volverá.
Okay, okay. Ah, hostia, perdón, perdón, perdón. Oh my goodness, miren, señor, háganme un enorme favor. Cuando usted se vaya a levantar, avíseme. Please, dime, teacher, ya vengo. Ok, termino con Andrea. Yes, Andrea. Please, I know you're always ready. Can you please invent sentences using important? Thank you.
My mom is important.
Good, comparative.
My mom is more important than of other person.
Excellent. Superlative.
My mom is most important.
My mom is the most important person in my life. Thank you so much. Good. Okay. I have 4 questions. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Can you please, Valeria, help me just to read? Solo a leer, please. Thank you. Question number 1.
Okay. Which is the most beautiful country for you?
Váyase preparando porque es pregunta de conversación utilizando superlativos. ¿Cuál es el país más hermoso para ti? ¿Y por qué, según su opinión? Question number 2.
Who's the oldest person in your family and why?
¿Quién es la persona más adulta o quién es el mayor en tu casa o en tu familia? ¿Y por qué? Cuando le digo por qué, es porque necesito que me diga también la edad, en este caso. Number 3.
What's your biggest dream? And why?
What's your biggest dream? ¿Cuál es tu mayor sueño? En number 4.
And which the coldest place in El Salvador? And
en
why?
Su opinión, ¿cuál es el lugar más helado en El Salvador? In this case, let's see. I'm going to choose, let's see, Jeremy, please turn on your audio. Thank you so much. Okay. I have 4 questions. Can you please choose only 2 for me to your teacher, please?
Okay. What's your biggest dream and why?
Okay. And be ready with your answer and your opinion too. Okay. My biggest dream. Acuérdense que aquí se puede inventar, que de hecho yo voy a inventar. My biggest dream is to travel. Because to travel, Jeremy, is one of my favorite hobbies. What about you, Jeremy? What's your biggest dream and why?
I think my biggest dream is travel to other countries like Japan.
Okay.
Because Japan is so beautiful and Japan has anime or they has a lot players, no, volleyball players, and mm-hmm. I would like to play with them.
Okay, good, excellent. Number two, please.
Okay, which is the most beautiful country for you and why?
I totally agree with you, Jeremy. In my personal opinion, the most beautiful country, ojo, mencione los superlativos para que practique. For me, the most beautiful country is Japan. As I said before, talking about Japan, I like the culture because they respect each other. I like the food because Japan has my favorite food, that is sushi. I love sushi. And number three, I love the technology. And in this case, how they use the technology for teaching. What about you, Jeremy? Which is the most beautiful country for you? Se va preparando Andrea.
My opinion, I have three favorite countries. First is the Japan.
Mm-hmm.
Japan, Dubai, and and how do you say Francia in English?
France, porque French es el idioma. France. Yes.
Okay, Japan, Dubai, and France, because I think these countries are very beautiful. Has a lot of place and the culture of this country is very, very amazing and beautiful. That's it.
Perfect. No, that is nice. Thank you so much, Jeremy. Okay, I'm going to continue with Andrea. Please, Andrea, the same dynamic. Choose two questions.
Which the coldest place in El Salvador?
Well, maybe I haven't visited El Pital. Yo nunca he estado en El Pital realmente, but supposedly people say it's one of the coldest places in El Salvador. But in my opinion, the coldest place, maybe Apaneca City, I don't know. What about you? What's your opinion? Which is the coldest place in El Salvador?
In my opinion, the coldest place in El Salvador is El Pital, or and also Los Planes.
Ah, yes. No cambia, no cambia porque es nombre propio. It's a proper name. Ah, okay.
Yes.
Andrea, have you ever visited El Pital?
Yes.
Do you recommend to me?
Yes, I recommend.
Why? Why?
Because it's, I don't know, it's very cold.
It's very cold.
Mm-hmm. And there are many, ¿cómo se dice árbol?
Trees?
Trees, yes. And
it has a very beautiful view, right? The view is amazing, right? View, vista.
Okay.
Is it beautiful?
Yes, it's beautiful. It's okay. Beautiful view.
Excellent. View. Excellent. View.
Okay.
Okay. Number two. Se va preparando, se prepara Valeria. Okay, yes, please, Andrea. Excuse me.
Who's the oldest person in your life? And
okay,
why?
In my family, the oldest person is my dad because he is 61, yes, 61 years old. What about you? Who's the oldest person in your family?
In my family, the oldest person is my grandma, because she is 59.
Excellent. Thank you, Andrea. Okay, Valeria, I'm going to continue with you quickly, please. Choose only two questions.
Me.
Yes.
What is your biggest dream and why?
Okay, I'm going to invent. My biggest dream is to have a baby. I'm inventing, okay? This is not true. My biggest dream is to have a baby. I want to get pregnant in 1 year, maybe, because I love kids. What about you? What's your biggest dream? Se prepara Walter.
Your dream is to travel to different countries.
Oh, really? For example?
For example, in the... how did it spell? In the Europa?
Europe, the continent.
Continent, Europe. Uh-huh. Europe, Asia.
Good, excellent. Number two.
Which is the coldest place in El Salvador and why?
So, well, in my opinion, maybe El Pital. I don't know, but it has 0 degrees. I don't know, because in my opinion, in my personal experience, I haven't been there. But supposedly El Pital is the coldest place in the, is one of the coldest place in El Salvador. What about you? What's your opinion about this one?
In my opinion, I went to the Palma in Chalatenango.
Uh-huh.
It's similar al Pital.
It's similar to Pita.
But the difference is in the day I hot, but I the colder.
Maybe in the morning is a kind of warm. Warm es cuando está entre cálido y entre heladito y calientito. Warm. In the morning is warm.
Is a
W-A-R-N. Yes, warm. Yes, RM, yes. So in the morning is warm.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. In the afternoon and evenings?
Is it cold? It's colder.
Cold. It's cold. Okay, excellent. Thank you. Thank you, Vale. Walter, are you ready?
Yes.
Good. Se prepara Christian. Okay, Walter, please choose only two questions to your teacher.
Which is the most beautiful country for you and why?
Well, I would like to visit Colombia. I haven't been there, Walter, but I would like to go to Colombia. For me, it's one of the most beautiful country. Specifically, I would like to go to Cartagena de Indias. Looks very beautiful. The beaches, the restaurants, looks very nice. What about you, Walter? Which is the most beautiful country for you?
For me, the most beautiful country is Russia.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Because it has the coldest weather.
Okay. Excellent. Number two, please.
What's your biggest dream and why?
My biggest dream, I'm going to invent. My biggest dream is to, I don't know. What can be my biggest dream? me quedo en blanco. My biggest dream is...
Casarse.
Okay. Reprendo. Okay. I'm going to invent. My biggest dream is to get married. I would like to... No, hombre. Yes, I'm going to invent. Okay, my biggest dream is to get married. I would like to get married with a very intelligent man, a very responsible man, and a very honest man. What about you, Walter? What's your biggest dream?
My biggest dream is to go to Europe.
Ah, okay. Specifically?
To Germany.
Okay. Why?
Because they have the most concert, metal concert in the world.
Okay, excellent. Thank you so much. Okay, Christian, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. In this case, can you, Marcelo, nos preparamos? I'm going to, let's see, just Marcelo and Genesis. Okay, Christian, please choose two questions quickly.
Okay, who's the oldest person in your family and why?
Okay, in my family, the oldest person is my uncle, because my uncle is 80 years old. He's a very old man. What about you? Who's the oldest?
In my family, my grandma is the oldest person in my family, mm-hmm. because she is 94 years old.
Okay, good. Number two.
Okay, what's your biggest dream and why?
Oh my God, again. My biggest dream, no, I'm kidding. My biggest dream, this is true. My biggest dream is to have a shelter. Do you know what I mean, shelter?
No.
Hey, any idea, students? Shelter for dogs. Un refugio, yes, a shelter, yeah. My biggest dream is to have a shelter because, the reason one is I love animals. To be more specific, I love dogs. So I would like to have a shelter to rescue animals from the street. What about you? What's your biggest dream?
I don't know, maybe climb the Everest, because the Everest is the biggest mountain in the world.
Wow. Do you think you have the ability to do it?
Yeah, I think.
Hey, how many
I climb two times with Alpha Karina.
Karina, ya terminaste, hija. No. Dice que quiere escalar el Monte Everest contigo, dice. Okay.
Yo voy.
Come on.
Thank you, Christian. Good. Thank you. Okay, Marcelo, are you ready? Se prepara Genesis, contigo termino.
No.
No, me encanta porque cuando decís no es cuando estás más preparado. Ok, Marcelo, no, solo dos preguntas. Only two.
Okay. Which is the most beautiful country for you? Why?
In my case, and this is true, I would like to go to Mexico because one of my favorite food is Mexican food. I would like to go to Mexico City, to be more specific, Cancun, because one of my favorite hobbies is to go to the beach. And as I said before, I love Mexican food. What about you, Marcelo? Which is the most beautiful country?
Tengo que hablar con el tema que...
Yes, using most beautiful.
Okay.
En tu opinión, ¿cuál es el país más bonito? The most beautiful country.
I don't know. In my opinion, the countries,
the most
the countries,
beautiful?
The Europe.
Europe, the continent.
Yes. Europe. Yes. Because I like this country. No.
The continent.
Continent. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Yes.
Excellent. Number two.
What's your biggest dream? Why?
My biggest dream is to make my students speak English fluently. Yes, this is one of my biggest dreams. What about you? What's your biggest dream? My biggest.
No estaba en la clase, pero.
My biggest.
My biggest dream is a soccer player and play a match the Champions League.
Wow, good.
fitness.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are really fitness. Y para los que no saben, yo creo que lo he dicho, yes. Marcelo sabe bastante, bastante jugar fútbol. Thank you, Marcelo. Nice. Okay, Genesis, I'm going to finish with you. Are you ready?
Yes.
Excellent. Thank you. The two questions, please.
Who is the oldest person in your family and why?
The oldest person in my family is my grandma. She is 84. Yes, she's 84 years old. What about you? Who's the oldest in your family?
The oldest person in my family is my grandfather. He's 109 years old.
Wow. This is true?
Yes, this is true.
Oh, wow, my goodness. Okay, number two.
What is your biggest dream?
My biggest dream is to make people speak English. This is true. What about you?
My biggest dream is to do university in Europe. Okay. London, to be specific.
Wow, that is good. Which career would you like to study?
I have two options, but I'm no security.
You're not sure. I'm not sure. O sea, para decir no estoy segura, I'm not sure.
I'm not sure.
Ah, okay. Okay, excellent. Thank you so much, Genesis. Nice. Okay, señores. Nosotros estuvimos viendo el tema de los adjetivos, comparativo, superlativo, forma normal, etcétera. O sea, aprendimos a decir, esto es más alto que esto es más grande que esto es más gordo que esto es más que esto, etc. Y el superlativo, este es el más de todos. Ahora bien, existe también una parte de la gramática que nos enseña a nosotros a comparar cuando dos cosas son iguales. Cuando un objeto A es igual que un objeto B. En este caso, tengo aquí una página de referencia que ustedes la tienen en su material y nada más la voy a leer como referencia, pero ustedes saben que yo siempre traigo más ejemplos para que ustedes se les hagan un poquito más fáciles, en este caso, de aprender. Le voy a pedir a Walter que me ayude a leer el primer párrafo, por decirlo así, y Andrea, me ayudas tú a leer el segundo párrafo. Ok, Walter, thank you. Desde donde dice Everest is, thank you.
Everest is higher than K2. Norway is further north than Denmark. Physics is more difficult than history. Bikes are more ecological than cars.
Perfect. Thank you, Walter. Okay, Andrea, the second paragraph, please. Thank you.
K2 isn't as high as Everest. Denmark isn't as far north as Norway. History isn't as difficult as physics. Cars aren't as ecological as bikes.
Okay, thank you so much. Please, my dearest students, pay attention to this video. I recommend to you, please, you should take notes. Okay, please pay attention.
Hello guys, welcome to another class. Me han pedido en varias ocasiones que explique cómo comparar usando el as. Realmente es muy fácil. Lo primero que tienes que tener en cuenta es que hay que aprender a usar los comparativos. En este canal ya tengo un video muy completo de cómo se pueden usar y cuáles son las reglas gramaticales. Te invito a que lo veas. Lo buscas así como cómo usar los comparativos. Pero también hay otra forma de comparar las cosas y es con el as, que sería en español como tan, como. Como por ejemplo decimos, esa persona es tan vieja como esta persona. O esa canción es tan buena como esa persona. Ese tan y ese como serían los as. Déjame darte un ejemplo. Si por ejemplo tú estás viendo dos casas que son de igual tamaño, tú puedes decir, this house is as big as this house. Ahí lo que estamos diciendo es que esta casa es tan grande como esta otra casa.
Si usted se fija, el adjetivo acá no cambia. Por eso es que ese tema es fácil. Antes decíamos, the green house is bigger than the red house. Pero cuando tengo dos objetos que son en este caso del mismo tamaño, no necesito pasar el adjetivo a bigger o biggest. Olvídese ahorita de eso. Porque como son, estoy hablando que el objeto en este caso es igual de grande que el otro, solo utilizo as, tan grande como. This house is as big as this house. Ojo, los alumnos siempre se confunden en esto. Ellos se lo aprenden muy bien porque como les digo, el adjetivo no cambia. Pero ellos hacen este error. This house as big as this house. ¿Cuál es el error? Omiten el verbo. Entonces, this house is. Si fuera en este caso un plural, si fueran estas casas, these houses are as big as these houses.
Casa. Otro ejemplo muy polémico, por cierto, sería este. This soccer player is as good as this soccer player. Bueno, cada uno tendrá su opinión. Eso es solamente un ejemplo. Pero también se puede usar en forma negativa. Como por ejemplo, this car is not as expensive as this car.
Supongamos que fuera positivo y yo quiero decir, este carro es tan caro como este otro carro. This car is as expensive as this car. Pero supongamos que yo lo quiero decir en negativo. Este carro no es tan costoso como el otro. This car, y solo le agrego la palabra not, como un auxiliar. This car is not as expensive as this car. Teacher, y lo puedo decir en una forma contractada. Claro que sí. This car, it isn't as expensive as this car.
O por ejemplo, this statue is not as old as this statue. En ocasiones también lo puedes hacer de forma interrogativa, como preguntándote algo. Como por ejemplo, is this band as good as this band?
Fácil, en pregunta solo cambia la posición del verbo. Ya no digo, this band is as good as this band. En pregunta, solo cambio la posición del verbo y de ahí lo demás queda igual. Is this band as good as this band? Ojo con la pronunciación de pregunta. Repito, en pregunta solo cambio la posición del verbo, teacher. Y si estuviéramos hablando en plural, lo mismo, are. Iría primero. Lo mismo. En este caso, singular. Is this van as good as this van?
Como puedes ver, es muy sencillo usar los comparativos cuando tenemos el referente de as. Así que la próxima clase, espero que seas tan juicioso como en esta clase. I'll see you later, my friends.
Oh. Okay. See you later. Okay. Let's continue. Can you please, I need a volunteer who wants to read the information. Just to read, please. Thank you.
Me.
Okay, Christian, go.
Okay. We can compare two things which are equal with us plus adjective plus us. We can add just, for example, for me, chemistry is just as difficult as
physics.
Physics, sorry. Sue is just as good at basketball as Nikki. We can use not, so, or as, plus adjective plus as to compare things instead of the comparative form of the adjective with them.
Thank you so much. For example, Cindy is beautiful. Normal, Cindy es hermosa. Cindy is beautiful. Adjetivo, beautiful. Acá no estoy comparando que ella es más bonita que, o que ella es la más bonita de todas. No, normal. Cindy is beautiful. Utilizando ahora, tengo dos personas, Carmen y Cindy. Carmen is as beautiful as Cindy. Estoy diciendo que las dos son iguales de bonitas. No estoy diciendo ni que la una es más bonita que la otra o que la otra es la más bonita de todas. Carmen is as beautiful as Cindy. Carmen es tan hermosa como Cindy. Tom is smart. Acuérdense que podemos decir intelligent, clever o smart. Tom is smart. Pedro is as smart as Tom. Pedro es tan inteligente como Tomás. Pedro is as smart as Tom. Negativo. My house, it isn't big. Mi casa no es grande. My house, it isn't big. My house, it isn't as big as yours. Mi casa no es tan grande como tu casa. My house, it isn't as big as yours. My job is complicated. My job is as complicated as yours. Tan complicado como tu trabajo. He is good at English. Él es bueno en inglés. I am, acuérdense que aquí el verbo to be. I am as good as him at English. Yo soy tan bueno como él en inglés. La última, my brother is tall. Ah, mi hermano es alto. My brother is tall. I am as tall as my brother. Yo soy tan alto como mi hermano. Preguntas. 5, 4, 3, 2. Thank you. Let's continue. Using as comparative, translate the sentences. I need a volunteer, please. Volunteer number one. Sí. La gira, ok. Andrea, y elige una, el siguiente, por favor.
Valeria.
Valeria, no, nos preparamos, vale, con la número dos. Ok, Andrea, la jirafa es tan alta como el elefante.
The giraffe is as big.
Alta, tall.
Tall. The giraffe is as tall as the elephant.
Let's see. The giraffe is as tall as the elephant. ¿Saben por qué a los alumnos les gusta ese tema? Porque el adjetivo no tenés que modificarlo. Pero como no estás ni comparando que uno es más grande que el otro, sino que en este caso los dos son igual de altos. The giraffe is as tall as the elephant. Thank you, Andrea. Muy bien. Valeria, number two. Pero before to continue, choose the next victim, please. Yes, quickly.
Marcelo.
Marcelo, nos preparamos con la número 3. Okay, vale. Yes, thank you.
The mouse is as little as the.
Hey, how, hey, by the way, yes, how do you say lagartija in English? Any idea, students? Lagartija.
Lizard.
Muy bien, excellent. Solo que aquí el adjetivo, thank you, Vale. The mouse is as small as the lizard. Thank you.
Teacher, yes. In the question, when
the difference?
They use a little and small.
For example, little is for food. For example, I want a little bit of cake. Un poquitito de pastel. I want a little bit of sugar, un poquitito de azúcar. Ojo, no solo se ocupa para las comidas, solo lo estoy dando una pequeña referencia. En el caso de cuando tenemos animales, small. Little, por ejemplo, pequeñito, pequeño, pero se ocupa más que todo cuando son cosas uncountable, cosas que no podemos contar. Yes. Y small es para objetos. Marcelo, yes. Mother, moderno. Antes de que me digas la respuesta, please, choose one student, quickly. Jeremy, Genesis, Jonathan, Walter. Jeremy. Ya. Ok, Jeremy, nos preparamos con la número 4. Ok, thank you, Marcelo. Okay. Mi teléfono está moderno.
My phone is as modern as yours.
Ok, let's see. My phone o my mobile. My mobile is as modern as yours. Teacher, ¿y por qué no puedo decir my phone? Es que claro que está correcto. Se puede decir my phone. Lo único que aquí, el teléfono celular, en este caso puede ser móvil o en general my phone. Ahí como usted guste. My mobile is as modern as yours. Thank you. Number 4, Jonathan, right? Yeah, o Jeremy. Yeah, yeah. Please, Jeremy, choose the next victim. Number 5.
¿Quiénes están?
Let's see, Genesis, your brother, Walter, Jasmine, Karina, no sé si ya finalizó. Walter. Ok, Walter, nos preparamos con las 5. Ok, Jeremy, la música en inglés es tan buena como la música en español.
Ok, the English music is as good as the Spanish music.
Okay, let's see. The English music is as good as Spanish music. Excellent. Walter, number 5. Aprender inglés es tan útil como aprender cualquier idioma.
Learn English is as useful as learn.
El verbo aprender inglés.
Learn English. It's as useful as learn another language.
Ok, otro idioma. Yo puse cualquier, no se preocupe, puede ser lo mismo. To learn English is as useful as learn any language. Cualquier idioma. O como dijo el other language. Ok, continue. Walter, please, choose one student. Genesis, Jonathan, or Jasmine. Jasmine, no sé si ya volvió. Please, choose one.
Genesis.
Okay, Genesis, number 1. Mi jardín es tan bonito como el tuyo.
My garden is as damn pretty as yours.
Uy, perdón, tenía apagado el micrófono. Solo quitémosle el damn. In this case, my garden is as pretty as yours. Please, choose one student, cualquiera, no importa si haya participado.
Jasmine.
Ok, Jasmine, are you ready?
Okay.
Excellent. Ok, yo estoy tan saludable como tú, healthy.
I am as healthy. Has you?
Okay, let's see. I am as healthy as yours. Thank you.
Yours.
Yes, tan saludable como tú. Choose one student, Jasmine, quickly.
Karina.
Karina, are you ready, Kari? Can you participate? Karina is working.
Okay.
Choose another Marcelo. One. Marcelo, please, are you ready? Number 3. Let's see, Marcelo, hello, 5, 4, 3, 2, volunteer, please. Volunteer, el cabello de Elena es tan corto. Yeah. Yes, thank you, Christian.
Elena's hair is as short as my sister's hair.
Okay, good. Elena's hair is as short as my sister's. Thank you, Christian. Choose one student, please. Number four.
Okay,
Jeremy, Jonathan. Jonathan, Andrea. Okay, thank you, Jonathan. Number four. Vivir en Francia es tan costoso como vivir en Japón.
Okay, live in France. In France is as expensive as live in Japan.
Let's see. To live in France is as expensive as live in Japan. Excellent. No, sí, está bien. Muy bien. Thank you. Choose the next victim, please, Jonathan.
Walter.
Okay, Walter, number five. Aprender francés. Fíjense que quise poner Francia y francés para que aprendamos la diferencia. No es que no la aprendamos, sino que para que no nos confundamos entre Francia y francés, el idioma. Aprender francés es tan difícil como aprender italiano.
Learn French is as difficult as to learn Italian.
Okay, let's see. To learn French is as difficult as learn Italian. Thank you, Walter. Perfect. Look at friends. Teacherino es amigos. Cuidado. Friends. Una palabra homófona. Cuando en este caso la palabra suena igual, pero obviamente tiene diferente significado. Homófonos. So, friends es el país y French en este caso es el idioma. Señores, con esto termino. La dinámica última es la siguiente. Tengo las preguntas, bueno, no son preguntas, son statements. Vegetables are as good as fruits. Los vegetales son tan buenos como las frutas. Ya le voy a explicar la dinámica. A sunny day is as good as rainy day. Un día soleado es tan bueno como un día lluvioso. Y la última, to play video games is as entertainment as play soccer. Jugar videojuegos es tan entretenido como jugar fútbol. La dinámica es la siguiente. Yo le hago una pregunta de las tres, un statement, usted me da su opinión y nos vamos saliendo del salón. Volunteer. I'm going to ask you just only one. Only one. Volunteer, yeah. Please. Okay, thank you, Christian. Let's see. Christian, what's your opinion? A sunny day is as good as rainy day.
For me, it's the same. Because in this season or in these 3 months, study from my house.
Okay.
Whatever, sunny or rainy, I'm working and studying in my house. I live the sad life.
I'm so sorry. Workaholic. I'm so sorry, Christiana.
Yeah.
Okay, see you on Friday. Bye. Good night,
hey,
Christian. Teacher,
thank you. See you on Friday.
Volunteer.
Yo, Jeremy.
Okay, Jeremy. Let's see. Jeremy, vegetables are as good as fruits. What's your opinion?
Uy, in my opinion, the fruits are very good, but vegetable, I hate vegetables. I will vomit. I will die if I eat vegetables.
Oh my God. Okay. Thank you. Good night. See you
okay,
Friday.
Good night, teacher.
Bye. Volunteer.
Me, teacher.
Okay, Karina. To play video games is as entertainment as play soccer.
For me, I prefer to play video games because I don't like play soccer.
Okay, it is one of your favorite hobbies, right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Clary. See you on Friday.
Bye, teacher.
Bye. Volunteer.
Me.
Jonathan. A sunny day is as good as rainy day.
Sunny is...
Soleado. My goodness. Okay. Yeah.
A sunny day is good, but I prefer rainy day because the weather is cold, and I love the weather cool.
The cold weather.
in the cold weather, yeah.
Okay, good. Me too. I agree with you. Thank you, Jonathan. See you on Friday. Bye. Volunteer.
So.
Okay, Andrea. Andrea number one, Jasmine number two. Andrea, to play video games is as entertainment as play soccer?
I disagree because in my opinion, to play video game is kind of, yes.
Okay.
And the play soccer is very interesting for me.
Excellent. Good night, Andrea. See you on Friday. Okay, Jasmine. Vegetables, okay, Marcelo, number two. Vegetables are as good as fruits. What's your opinion, Jasmine?
Yes, in my opinion, this is correct. Vegetables are vegetables? As good as fruits.
Do you like vegetables?
Yes, I like veggies. And I like the fruits.
Yes, me too. I love both. Excellent. Thank you, Jasmine. Good night. See you on Friday.
Good night, teacher.
Okay, Marcelo. To play video games is as entertainment as play soccer?
Es que teacher no entendí. Es que...
It's a simple question. What, okay. Oh, for example, what do you prefer? To play video games or to play soccer?
I prefer the play soccer.
Why?
Because it's my favorite hobby.
Yes, simple. That's it. Thank you. Good night, Marcelo. See you on Friday.
Yes. I'm sorry. Okay.
Bye.
A la okay. Otra sí estoy en toda la clase. Ya va a ver.
Thank you. Vaya hijo. Okay. Genesis or Walter? Volunteer.
Me.
Okay, Genesis. A sunny day is as good as rainy day.
I disagree. I prefer rainy days. It's more relaxing to me.
Okay, me too. I totally agree with you. Thank you. Bye, Genesis. Okay, Walter, are you ready?
Yes.
Right. Excellent. Let's see. Choose one, you. Because you are the new student, choose one.
Okay, to play video games is as entertaining as play soccer.
Yes, for what's me, your opinion? Game,
for me, play video game is the most exciting hobby.
How often do you play video games?
Like 3 or 4 days a week.
In my case, I don't have any idea about video games. I remember I used to play Mario Kart and Yoshi, Mario Bros, and something like that. But I don't have any idea about playing video games. So tell me about you. Do you have another hobbies?
Listening to music, I think is my favorite hobby.
And what do you prefer? Pop music, Christian music, or English music?
English music, and I like the rock and metal.
Ah, good. Music. Do you like the 90s music or the 80s?
80s and both.
Both.
I like both. Yes.
Okay, nice. Hey, tell me about your job. What do you do?
I work in a bank.
Mm-hmm.
I am in the IT.
Okay, good. Okay. Hey, how do you feel the class?
It was good.
Do you like it?
Yes, I like.
Do you feel comfortable or not?
No, I feel comfortable.
Okay. Comfortable. Yes. Okay, nice. Do you have any question to your teacher?
Yeah, it's you send all the before the class, you send the link to Zoom, right?
Yes, I always send the link in this case before the class. I always say to the WhatsApp group, don't worry about it. And now I'm recording the class too. When the class finished, I'm going to send the video to you if you want to watch or if you want to study again the class.
Oh, okay.
Yes, I'm going to send the class maybe in 15 or 20 minutes because I'm recording the class. This is one of the dynamics. I always record the class and I always send before classes, after classes, yes. Do you have any question or everything is clear, like horchata?
Everything is clear, I think.
Okay, Walter, disculpar que lo agarré preguntas. Lo que pasa es que fíjense que siempre que ingresa alguien a academia, siempre yo le hago una entrevista, así como la que le acabo de hacer a usted, pero se tarda un poquito más, ¿verdad? Y con usted, como todo fue tan rápido, no tuve ese chance, pero me dejé guiar un poco por lo que Gaby Jiménez me dijo, ¿verdad? Entonces me dice, no, mire, dice que él ya ha estudiado en otro lugar. Entonces yo dije, bueno, vamos a ver qué tal. Pero en realidad, ¿cómo sintió la clase? ¿Qué le pareció?
No, me pareció interesante.
Vaya, ok. Y como le decía, el link, siempre yo mando el link antes de que iniciemos la clase en el grupo. Siempre lo mando. Aunque el link es el mismo. Aunque yo no le envíe, ellos ya saben que en el mismo link ellos pueden ingresar.
Ah, ok. Está bien.
Ok, Walter, pasa una... Yes, dígame, perdón.
No, solo ahí la... ahí usted me... Como está ahí, me va a evaluar, ¿verdad? Para ver si estoy bien en el nivel y todo eso.
Sí, porque... Ajá. Sí, de hecho yo lo, bueno, usted lo ingresé en este nivel 7, porque yo creo que a usted lo que le falta es práctica, siento yo, práctica.
Sí.
Y tiene algunos detalles de gramática. Obviamente yo creo que quizás había dejado de practicar inglés un poquito, ¿verdad? Pero en este caso lo puse en este nivel porque si lo ponía en el nivel más avanzado que tenía, no quería yo que se fuera a frustrar. Y si lo ponía en los niveles más bajos, mi miedo era que usted se fuera a aburrir, porque con los tengo niveles bajos también, pero bueno, y usted me dice, mire, teacher, no sé si le parece o no sé, porque tengo niveles un poco más bajos, pero mi miedo era que usted se fuera a aburrir, pues yo decía, porque los otros alumnos pues están viendo el pasado simple, el presente continuous, o al menos que usted diga, no, mire, a mí me gustaría volver a repasar todo eso, pero igual también los horarios, quiero ver. Sí, los horarios de ellos creo que sí le chocaría porque el horario de ellos es de 5 de la tarde.
Sí. No, pero ahorita me pareció bien.
Ah, va. No. Sí, bueno, entonces, y cualquier duda o consulta, estamos a la orden. Oye.
Vaya, bueno.
Ok, Walter, buenas noches.
Igual, adiós.
Bye.